good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another 3D printing video. So let's get cracking. Friends, today we are going to be printing with the Mingda Magician X2. I have not made videos with it lately, but that is only because it is constantly printing. I have had zero problems with this printer. Before we get started though, I want to show you something. I'm going to go to the Magician X2, I'm going to manage the printer, and I'm going to go to the machine settings. I have modified my start code. Yours should, if you did it the way the video showed initially, have these. I am putting semicolons by those four, and then I've pasted in this. All it does is move to the left side of my bed and it draws two lines to get started before it gets going on the print. I just like the way it's been working, and since I have done this, I have stopped using skirt on my prints so they actually print just a little quicker. This code will be in the description of this video, so you can simply copy it and paste it in. Just remember to put semicolons by those if you want to use it on your X2 printer as well. Now friends, today's design is going to be one of my favorite ones. Of course, I've got them stored in my 3D modeling folder, and this one is a special top. It's called the Top of Mount Pisgah. Here is my Top of Mount Pisgah. Now, I climb Mount Pisgah every day, and I leave little trinkets up there. I like this one because it is a top found on the top of Mount Pisgah, and as you can see, I have the words in it. It prints in place, so it's reasonably fast. When I was doing this in my classroom, I had trouble with some of my printers using Cura because they would fall off the bed. I'm going to try and solve that by moving down here, and this one is actually going to use some raft. Now, when you bring out the raft, I always like to check and see how much raft there is. If you search the settings, you'll see that right here my margin was set at 15. I don't think I need that much. I'm gonna set it at 3 millimeters extra. Now I can cancel this out. And then also right now I am not printing with PLA. I am instead printing with PETG. So I'm gonna go over here to generic and I'm gonna pick my PETG. And as we zip down the settings, you can see I do 0.3 layers, wall thickness of 0.8, top bottom of 0.8, infill of 20%. 240 for the printing temperature, 70 for the build plate, and 60 for the speed. I have got retraction enabled, but I am not turning on Z-Hop. And of course, we already talked about the adhesion, and there's no support. I have got my SD card, so I'm going to save it to the removable disk, and let's take it over to the printer and do some printing. Alrighty, friends, so let's insert the SD card. Once again, I love that it says this side down. We're going to move over here and hit print from the SD card. If we look right here, there is the top of Mount Pisgah and confirmed. Alrighty, friends, so the print was successful. Let's snap it off. I had that raft, so I'll pop that off real quick. Friends, this is a Tinkercad design. I'll put a link to the tutorial up in the corner. It's super simple, super fun, and as you can see, works like a champ. Now, part of the lesson was to see if we could make one that spins for 60 seconds. This is a pretty small area to do those tests on, but I do have a video where I'll share where some of my students actually did get one that spun for 60 seconds. How cool is that? Once again, my Tinkercad Top of Mount Pisgah. And the Mingda Magician X2 is absolutely crushing it. Friends, as I wrap up this video, I just want to remind you of my website, HLModTech.com. As you can see, I've got the page about 3D printing. You can see all the printers that I have or have worked with here. And also down at the bottom, there is a sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. And of course, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Don't forget, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.